Hi guys, welcome back. I'm Ian Laspina, and we are in the middle of moving into a new house, so we don't have everything unpacked yet, and that's why I haven't been able to put out a new video in the last couple weeks. I do now have my desktop PC and internet connection hooked back up, so I can at least do one of these desktop capture style videos. So we're going to continue talking about internet resources for medieval research. And one place I want to draw your attention to is Pinterest. It's not just for recipes and home decor. People do use it very extensively for documenting images of different medieval things. So Pinterest is kind of a double-edged sword. You just got to be aware that things aren't necessarily vetted on Pinterest. So anybody can write whatever they want in one of the comments on one of their pins. So someone can write something like visor bassinet, circa 1400, German steel, brass and leather, and it be a picture of, you know, a dog. So just be careful what you're looking at. It may or may not be an actual original, but if they do give information, you can always check out the information and see if it's real. Plus, if it's pinned from a place like metmuseum.org, then you know that you can follow through the link and it'll actually take you to the source. So the Metropolitan Museum of Art, yes, this is a good link. But these are mostly all vetted images. In my particular side-hinged bassinet album, just so you guys are aware, and but be careful when you're just looking around on Pinterest. Another Pinterest album I want to draw your attention to is a friend of mine, Tom Billiter. He has a ton of pins here, over 24,800 pins, but most of those are coming from this particular album, which I really want to draw your attention to, and that's photos from Matthias Goll's PhD thesis. There's over 17,000 images in this. Thank you, Tom, for taking the time to actually upload all of these. I'll also provide a link to the actual PhD thesis itself if you want to check that out. It comes with all of these images. But there, like I said, there's over 17,000 images of armor in here. Now, you do have to be careful. We've discovered that there are a lot of fakes mixed in with some of the images in his thesis, and they are not labeled. So if you see some like really wonky looking pieces of armor, it may be a fake, just so you're aware. Now, you'll see on all of the images, it has like a reference arm number, refarm 5140000, refarm 5139, and so forth. So that is the numbering scheme that Matthias Goll used in his PhD dissertation to reference the different pieces of armor. The nice thing about it is you can actually search by that. So if you know you want every image on this particular arm harness here, refarm 5131, you can actually go and type it in to Pinterest, hit enter, and it will return all of the images labeled reference arm 5131. Sometimes you'll get some erroneous results, but that's just kind of the nature of Pinterest. Like, I don't know why it returned refarm 1207 in addition to what I typed in, but sometimes it does that. So just double check the comments down below and you'll make sure that you're actually looking at the right thing. So if your interest is specifically the 14th century and you don't want to look through 17,000 images, another friend of mine, Augusto Boer Brandt, he has taken all of the 14th century pieces of armor from the Matthias Goll thesis and collated them into their own albums. So you can see here, 14th century arm harness, gauntlets, torso protection, great helms, clap visor, bassinets, leg harness, etc. So if we go here to gauntlets, you'll see that these are all of the 14th century gauntlet photos. And again, they will have their ref arm number associated with them in the comments. So again, if you wanted to look up something specific, you could. Now, in addition to that, so like if we go here to side shots, he's kind of taken all the bassinet photos from profile. So different ways that you can look at them here. Now, if you want more information on any of the particular pieces of armor from that PhD thesis, so let's go into torso protection and let's see. So like here, reference arm 3906, photograph 001. If you wanted more information on that particular coat of plates, go to the University of Heidelberg and you can download the PhD thesis here, Iron Documents, Interdisciplinary Studies on the Technology of Late Medieval European Plate Armor Production between 1350 and 1500 by Matthias Goll. Download it and it will come with it's large, it's over 3 gig, but when you get it, you'll get two directories, and there'll be the text of the actual thesis and then a reference directory. Within that reference directory, you'll have PDFs for each of those reference armors. So you'll go to ref arm 3906.pdf and open it, and it will have all of the cataloging details on that specific piece of armor. So any of the things in these 17,000 images that you want information on, it will have a PDF for that reference arm inside that PhD thesis in those documents for you to look up and get more information on it. And finally, if you want to have some sort of interactive discussion about things like these pieces of 14th century armor and other original pieces of artwork and things like that, I want to draw your attention to Facebook real quick. This is the 14th Century European Armors Group. It is run by Augusto from this Pinterest page. And what he does is, oh, by the way, it is a closed group, so you will require permission to join from the moderators. But if you are interested, please go ahead and sign up. But the reason it's like that is we get a lot of spammers and people who want to sell stuff, and we need a way to weed those people out. So that's why it is a closed group. And what we do within this group is discuss a lot of the images from the of original 14th century armor and of original 14th century artwork, and discuss what we're seeing. Because what we want to do is look at the original source material. One of the worst traps you can fall into as a reenactor is to copy other reenactors without doing the research for yourself. That's one of the reasons I always try to provide primary source references for the things that I show in my videos, because I don't want you guys just copying me, because it's the way I do things. I want you to copy the originals, because that's what the real goal is here. So within this group, we do a lot of discussion on interesting images that we come across, interesting pieces of armor that we find. Just trying to kind of expand our knowledge of the original objects. And so please consider signing up for 14th century European armors. You should just be able to, search for that XIV century European armors with a U in armor at the top, and find the group and then request to join, and Augusto would be able to approve you on there. And I guess I would be remiss to not show, while we're on Facebook here, my own Facebook page. So if you haven't liked it already, please come check out the Knight Errant Facebook page. I do share more than just my video uploads on here. I also share other things that I think might be of interest to you guys, other Facebook pages and other images, articles and things like that, regarding medieval material culture and things like that. So, hope you guys found that one useful. As always, when I get my video equipment back up and running, we will start getting the other type of videos back out to you guys. So, until then, take care.
libraries ounces. Out there and hoping that I'll they've scanned stuff and that their user computer so that interfaces are friendly enough well, that you can actually you find prefer. What you're looking for.
And I've got both sometimes sets you do have to do that, but pieces
oftentimes you'll find the right, same so thing that you're looking out for here right here on